بير باب
وقفت حروفي في ربوع بياني وأتى القصيد بأروع الألحان.
قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم ثم تردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون.
Then Allah says in Surah Al Imran as well as in Surah Al Anbiya as well as in Surah Al Ankabut, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every soul shall taste death. I will taste it and you will taste it. Those before us have already tasted it. Those to come after us will also taste it. After they have become alive, the next step is death. You can't live and then you have another birth and then a third birth and a fourth birth. No, you are born, the next step is death. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. Then Allah tells us, look, you will never ever be able to run away from death. Death is something that is going to come to you. So the best option you have is to prepare for it. That's the best option. In fact, you have no other option. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah An-Nisa,
أينما تكونوا يدرككم الموت ولو كنتم في بروج مشيدة.
No matter where you are, death shall come to you even if you are in the loftiest of towers. Some people think we don't want to die, so let's go up. So they start spiraling right up the building. Wallahi, the angel of death will get there as well. In fact, it might even become easier to take you away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ahzab. More clear verses.
قُلْ لَنْ يَنْفَعَكُمُ الْفِرَارُ إِنْ فَرَرْتُمْ مِنَ الْمَوْتِ أَوِ الْقَتْلِ وَإِذَا لَا تُمَتَّعُونَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا.
Tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will never ever be able to run away from death. Running away will never ever help you. No matter where you are, you will not be able to run away from your death. If you think you are going to run away for a short moment, then you should remember when the fixed time of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes, it will never ever be delayed. And that brings us to the very next verse in Surah Nuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
إِنَّ أَجَلَ اللَّهِ إِذَا جَاءَ لَا يُؤَخَّرُ.
Indeed, the fixed time of Allah, when it comes, it will not be delayed. When the fixed time of death for anyone comes, or when the expiry date of anything comes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it will not be delayed. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah An-Nahl and in other places in the Quran, not only will it not be delayed, but you won't even be able to bring it forward. We were speaking about number 56 a few days ago, if you recall. And how some people make a dua that, Ya Allah, let this person die. I don't know if you recall what we said. The reality is we will never be able to bring someone's death closer than what Allah has decided. So those duas, we should stop making them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us happiness in the dunya as well as in the akhirah. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nahl.
فَإِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهُمْ لَا يَسْتَأْخِرُونَ سَاعَةً وَلَا يَسْتَقْدِمُونَ.
Indeed, when their prescribed time comes, they will not be able to delay it by a moment, nor will they be able to bring it forward by a moment. Those verses we read tonight. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how a person does not die on their own accord. They die under the control of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is Allah who decides that they will die in this particular way. And it is Allah who permits it and allows it. So when a person commits suicide, there is a question. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Did they change the decree of Allah and died quicker? The answer is no, they did not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always knew that they were going to die in that particular way. But they will be held responsible for having taken their lives in that particular way. because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not impose it on them to die in that particular way. Had He imposed it on any one of us, any of our deeds, if they were imposed on us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it would be unfair for Him to hold us accountable for something we have no choice about. The only question we are going to be asked on the day of Qiyamah rotates around the issue of choice. How did you use your choice? Where we gave it to you. So in fact, let's word it another way. Any question you will be asked on the day of judgment will be connected to how you utilized your choice whilst you were alive. There are no questions connected to any other subject. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. So your prayer, you had the choice. How did you use your choice? If someone killed you, you didn't have a choice in that regard, you won't be asked that question, that why did someone kill you? That person will be asked a question. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all understanding.
وقفت حروفي في ربع بياني وأتى القصيد بأروع الألحان. وقفت حروفي.